So today we will talk about the Ken Betwa Interlinking River Project. Why news? Because Union Cabinet recently approved the implementation and also clear the funding related to the Ken Betwa Interlinking Project. Remember that this is a transfer of surplus water from the Ken River to the Betwa River, and both are situated in the Madhya Pradesh, and also Ken and Betwa River is the both are the tributaries of Yamuna. So let's talk about. So why news? As I have told you that recently the Union Cabinet approved the funding and implementation of Ken Betwa Interlinking of Rivers project with a total of 44,205 crore, and project will complete in 8 years. So remember that. So now the 2021 and now around the 2029 at least. If we talk about the interlinking project, then what is the and who mooted the idea and what is the history related to this? So let's talk about. So remember that is the first project under the National Perspective Plan, and remember that this National Perspective Plan was made by the Irrigation Ministry of that time in August 1980. So remember that. This is basically for the interlinking of river, which envisages the transfer of water from water surplus basin where the flooding surplus actually which causes flooding in the area. So what happened that there will be a transfer from where actually the flooding is taking place due to the surplus water and the scarce, and the surplus water will take away and transfer to the deficit basin or deficit river. So remember that. And basin where actually there is a drought and the scarcity through the inter basin water transfer project. This is the what is known as the interlinking project if you talk about. Then remember that this idea was first mooted by the then irrigation minister. Remember that at that time there is a irrigation ministry. So Dr. K.L. Rao is the famous name in this regard. If you talk about, in August 1980, the Ministry of Irrigation prepared the National Perspective Plan for the Water Resource Development and envisages inter-basin transfer. Further, if you talk about the National Perspective Plan comprised the two components. First is for the Himalayan River Development and another is for the Peninsular River Development. Remember that Himalayan basically consists of the north and the eastern section, and Peninsular basically the central India and somewhat towards the south India. So remember that. And that is, and total there are the 30 interlinking project, and out of that the 16 comes under the Peninsular River Development and the 14 comes under the Himalayan River Project, and total is 30 if you talk about. Remember that. So earlier government actually what happened didn't give much importance to the interlinking project. But interlinking river was revived during the Atal Bihari Vajpayee government, and the Ken Betwa River Link project is one of the 16 projects under the Peninsular River Development. This is what is the national perspective and how this concept is came and who gave this concept. Now let's talk about the brief history about the Ken Betwa Interlinking River project. If you talk about the idea of linking Ken with the Betwa got a major push in August 2005. Remember that. And in 2008, the Union government actually declared it as a national project and included as a part of the PM's package for development of drought-prone Bundelkhand region. And one of the main reason why there is a Ken Betwa region, basically to provide the irrigation facility in the Bundelkhand region, and there is a huge water deficit in the Bundelkhand region according to the report. So remember that if you talk about. And after all the details report project was prepared and was sent to the UP government, Madhya Pradesh government and the Central Water Commission, which consists under the Union government, Ministry of Jal Shakti if you talk about. So further, as you know, recently in March or April 2021, there was an agreement signed between the memorandum was signed basically between the UP government and Madhya Pradesh government and also the Union government, and this is how actually this project is came into effect. So now let's talk about the Ken Betwa Interlinking Project and what are the related features of this. Remember that it is a transfer of water from the Ken River to the Betwa River. Remember that it is not the river from the Betwa River to Ken River, but from the Ken River to the Betwa River. Remember that. And if you talk about this, some facts, then remember that Ken and Betwa originated in the MP. So both are the river originated in the Madhya Pradesh and both are the tributaries of Yamuna. These are the some facts which is very important. And if we talk about Ken meets with Yamuna in the Banda district of the Uttar Pradesh. So where actually the Ken meets where from the transfer will take place, actually meet with Yamuna in the Banda district of UP and with Betwa in the Hamirpur district of Uttar Pradesh. Remember that. If you talk about one of the most important fact, if you talk about, then remember that Ken River passes through the Pana Tiger Reserve, which is in Madhya Pradesh. Remember that. We will also talk about the implications on the Pana Tiger River, but this is very important if you talk about. Now, what is the main purpose? Main purpose is to irrigate the drought-prone Bundelkhand region, or which actually passes through the various districts around the 13 districts of the UP and Madhya Pradesh, if you talk about. Then remember that this region is spread across the district of the Jhansi, Banda, Lalitpur and the Mahoba, which is in UP, and Timargarh, Pana, Chhatarpur in the Madhya Pradesh, and there will be also 230 meter concrete canal. Canal is basically the way actually through which the water passes. So remember that 233 concrete canal will also make. If you talk about, there will be a 27 meter high Dudhwan dam will also be built. Dam is a basically of artificial technique which store the water. So for the storage of water, this kind of artificial dam will build. So through this dam, there will be a storage of water will take place. If there is any flooding in the Ken River, then there will be a transfer and a storage in dam will take place. So remember that. If you talk about another important features of this Ken Betwa linking project, then we'll irrigate the 10.62 lakh hectare. So it is also beneficial to the farmers as well, especially in the Bundelkhand region if you talk about. Then remember that provide the drinking water to around the 62 lakh people. Obviously, it will boost the Har Ghar Jal Se Nal Yojana, is the very, very important scheme which is going on by the government of India. So remember that. And obviously, 103 megawatt of hydropower which is produced through the water, remember that, and 27 megawatt of solar power will also be built, and this is a kind of energy will be provided to this region of UP and Madhya Pradesh as well. So, if you talk about the benefits of the interlinking project, then remember that reducing actually the drought and also the reduces the flood-like condition. So, obviously, if there is a deficit water which is causing flood, so obviously there are causing flood in one situation, so there will be a surplus transfer of water will take place from flooding area to other areas. So, obviously, it will reduce the drought in that area where actually the deficit water, and obviously, it will simultaneously reduce the flood area in that actually there is a surplus water. So, remember that. If you talk about reduces the farmer's disease stress, as you know, irrigation is very, very important to produce crop, and if there is any shortage of rainfall, then obviously irrigation is required. So that is also reduces the farmer distress from the transfer of surplus water to the deficit water. So remember that. Electricity production will take place. So obviously it will provide to the electricity to the household as well, and also it might be to industry as well if you talk about. Then remember that rejuvenate the biodiversity through the interlinking project, and remember that. So there will be an analysis will take place, and if there is any lack in the area, then obviously it will rejuvenate the biodiversity. And if you talk about, it will also provide the drinking water to the household and boost to the Har Ghar Jal Se Nal Yojana by the government of India. Remember that. And obviously day by day and by 2040 it will be a more than around the 500 million people will lack of water. So obviously it will meet the demand of the drinking water. If you talk about reduce the other climatic event, as I have told you, the flood, and sometimes if you talk this water also part is the cyclone. So remember that this kind of event will take place, and this is the benefits of the interlinking project. Obviously there are the some issues. If you talk about the issues, then remember that there are the some social causes. Firstly, the displacement of people around 10,000 will take place through this project. This is the very, very. So obviously, if there is a displacement from that area, so there is a rehabilitation issue. Rehabilitation is one of the main important which you need to provide, and it will cost. So obviously. So remember that. Huge economy cost, as I told you, not only for the project, but also for the displacement and other areas if you talk about. Then remember that reducing the area of the Pana Tiger Reserve. Why Pana Tiger Reserve is very, very important? Because it is a critical tiger habitat. And if there will be a reduction in area, around the 7.6% will take place through this project. So it is in a heavy dent to the tigers. Obviously, day by day, actually, this area is shrinking of the tiger habitat. So remember that. So it will also might threat the tiger population also through this. Remember that. So what is the way forward of these all issues? So obviously the government is taking care of all the issues and trying to provide as effective as solution is possible. So remember that. All the environmental clearance done. So remember that if you talk about the Central Water Commission, there is a technical area which is provided by this, so that clearance has been done. Ministry of Environment and Forest, which actually reduces this kind of thing. Ministry of Tribal Affairs approval has been take place, and which will actually cause the displacement of people basically in the rural area. And obviously in others, there are some technical committee also set up to look at such kind of project, and it also gave the approval if you talk about. Then remember that for protection of the Pana Tiger Reserve, now what government is said that we will integrate the three wildlife sanctuary. Firstly, the Nauru Dredi and Rani Durgavati, if you talk about, another is the Ranipur. Remember that Ranipur in the UP and these two are in the Madhya Pradesh. So these will integrate with the Pana Tiger River. So what is the reduction in area will take place? It might fill through these three wildlife sanctuary, it might fill. Remember that. If you further talk about, then remember that there will be a special purpose vehicle called the Ken Betwa Link Project. Authority will be set up for the implementation of this project, and it will also look at the technical aspect and the financing aspect of the Ken Betwa River Linking Project. In future, obviously, there will be a National Interlinking of Rivers Authority will be set up, and it will also look at the implementation and financing task, and it has also the power, and it will be an autonomous body, and it will also be have a power to set up a special purpose vehicle for the individual linking project. So remember that, just like the Ken Betwa Project Link Authority. If you talk about the summary of this video, then you need to remember that there will be a transfer from the Ken River to the Betwa River. Remember that, and both are the rivers is situated in the Madhya Pradesh, and both are the tributaries of Yamuna. This is the main important thing. And what is the main purpose? Main purpose is basically to provide the irrigation in the Bundelkhand region. Remember that this is the very, obviously there is a drinking water will be provided, there will be a project like hydropower, solar power, there will be a dam and canal will also be set up. So these are the very very important thing, and one of the most important thing that the Ken Betwa Linker interlinking project, it passes through the Pana Tiger Reserve, and which is situated in the Madhya Pradesh, and remember that it also linked to the Maharashtra. So this is all about. Thank you guys.